when you go to use them, when you're coming up to the taxi driver, the back doors are automatic. Hey, my name's Jason. I live in Wellington. I'm a VFX worker and I work in the movies. VFX worker, we sort of do like special effects in the movies now. There's a lot of work when films are done, is usually done on either green screens and pickup shots, and we have to make these wonderful, like crazy environments that fulfill. I think one of the first things, or like the main thing that inspired me to go to Japan, especially when I was growing up, a lot of the things, films that I watched were animation heavy. The movies that I watched were created and usually based in Japan. So I think, thinking back, that's probably where my original curiosity was to go and actually visit the places that I had seen portrayed in films. Yeah, I was sort of expecting something like a lot more claustrophobic than what it was. And like the coolest thing for me aesthetically was how layered everything was. The subways and the monorails and the highways and the bridges and stuff like that. Even like everything and even the buildings are all layered. And you don't get that here. And I think that was the coolest, like one of the most amazing things to see, I think. Yeah, like one of the stories I heard was before I first went to Japan was the escalators where everyone always stands on the left-hand side to give space for all the people that are in a hurry.
You don't do that in New Zealand.
No, we don't do that. Like usually in New Zealand, we've got an escalator. You're taking up the entire space for yourself on the entire trip down the escalator.
I didn't even notice that in New Zealand. So I was naturally doing this for other
I
people.
do. I actually I do that in New Zealand now. After going to Japan, I always stand left on the escalator going down. But no, like usually we hang off it or something like that, or something weird. But yeah, that was pretty incredible to see. Yeah, and super polite as well to people that are in a hurry. Portrayal of like Japan as being like a very high-tech society, all the cool gadgets, all the cool new things. It was very surprising on our trip, last trip over there, when my partner was withdrawing some money from an ATM machine and then whipped out a book to scan in afterwards, and I was asking her what that was, and she was mentioning that it was a bank book to record all the withdrawals and deposits and stuff. That was a very, very, very big surprise. All our stuff now like is mostly done electronically. We used to have bank books, but that was like quite a few years ago. A lot of the things that we buy and pay bills now is all done over the internet. Like even cash, like you don't really tend to see too many people like pay by cash for things anymore. Yeah, and that was a very interesting thing to manage while traveling around Japan is just like having so much cash on me. I don't tend to like carry around that much cash ever. Usually, yeah, just maybe a small amount every now and then, but that's about it. Everything is all electronic and done on the card. Yeah, well, we just use the like internet banking. Internet banking is like very big, where depending which bank you're with, and you can track all of your accounts, you can set up your own accounts and track everything that way, statements, monthly statements. But I think New Zealand was like the first country to even, we were like the guinea pigs for the FPOS card and stuff. I'm not too sure, like, if do you guys, did the FPOS ever make it? Like, did FPOS ever make it to, like, for Japan and stuff? Or?
Not so cool.
It's just credit card, isn't it? Japanese taxis was a bit of a shock. There's just so many of the same like brand. Like, I think it's like the Toyota Crown or something, but it's like a 1990 or something version. And they're everywhere. They're used everywhere. And 2 years ago was the last time. So I've been to Japan twice, and yeah, I think it was about 2 years ago now. When you go to use them, when you're coming up to the taxi driver, the back doors are automatic. So you don't have to open or close them. The driver does it all for you. Here in New Zealand, a lot of the taxis now are like either hybrids, so like Priuses or something like that. But you still have to, like, everything is all manual. So, and a habit as well. So whenever we used a taxi while in Japan, I'd always reach out to the door to try and close it or something. And the driver would always politely just go, "Oh, no, damn it." But yeah, that and the queues for like the trains, especially I notice it at the end, like towards the end of the day, like coming back, everyone's finished work and finished school and are piling into the trains. It's not like a big mob all like pushing for like one of the doorway entrances. Yeah, like everyone is super politely like lined up at each, and it's really cool because there's like little queue, like line markings on the ground where you can line up, and the trains just come in and like everything is lined up and super efficient, and people come out one side and everyone goes in a line. And I guess it's probably the only way, but it's to have something with so many people work so well in the train station. Oh yeah, yeah. I thought it was just like it's all for yourself. Like everyone just like try and runs for the door and hopefully run and get a seat before anybody else. And yeah, but yeah, that was pleasantly surprised.